Good evening. I'm Greg Floyd.
Hi, everyone. I'm Liz Bishop. Four people are in police custody tonight after a five-hour standoff in Schenectady.
A shooting and a stabbing are under investigation in Schenectady. The shooting victim was pronounced dead at the scene, and the stabbing victim has been taken to the hospital.
We start tonight with breaking news out of the city of Schenectady, where police say they have cleared away an unruly crowd of nearly 200 people on Becker Street. More than 1,000 high school students are fans of the Schenectady Fights Facebook page.
For the last 25 hours, Schenectady police have been looking for whoever fired shots at a family function. Killing Falsetti had been wounding to his mother.
The killer is not yet in custody.
Life could be a dream, life could be a dream, do 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 shaboom. Life could be a dream, shaboom. If I could take you up in paradise up above, shaboom. If you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream, sweetheart, hello, hello again, shaboom, and open, we'll meet again, boom, ding dong, ding dong, lang, 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 oh, 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 pip, a bib, a rob, a dib, oh, life could be a dream, if only all my precious plans would come true, if you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
I'm an IB diploma candidate. So IB, the way I describe it, is kind of like an AP course on steroids. So it's kind of where you take these, basically your common classes, but they amp them up to a higher like intensity. I think that IB gives you an average class, but it makes you think on a broader spectrum, and it pushes you not to kind of like go past the bar of thinking, but kind of like setting the bar of thinking. I think IB teaches you that while we may be in a class and you have one opinion or perspective and I have one perspective, that neither of us are right nor wrong, and the only way that we can prove ourselves more credible is with more evidence and clarity.
TOK is, they basically talk about how you know what you know. So how can you, like, how do you know that the wall is white? How do you not know that it's black? And they try to go into specifics but not make it too much of a philosophy class. And they try and use, like, there's eight areas of knowledge and then eight ways of knowing. And they try to help you learn more about that, so.
I really like connections that we make with teachers and stuff. And I like how you can always go back to your teachers that you've had in, like, your previous grades, and they'll still, like, interact with you and ask you how you're doing.
I would have to say my favorite IB class is IB History. Last year I had Mr. Bub. Mr. Bub, I don't know, like, I've always loved history, but I feel like he really pushed me to think about it more rather than just looking on the surface of what happened in history. Like, he made me say, like, why did it happen in history? How did it shape what happened 1776? How did it shape 2018? I think every day all of us stress things, whether it's Mr. Bub's dirt quizzes or something like that. And I think organizing the walkout really showed me how there's such bigger issues in the world and how we shouldn't really stress the small stuff. I worked with a few other classmates, Alyssa, Harry, Nana, and I always say Harry Mann, she gets mad when I say that, another Dominique Dunlap, Shayla Kerr, and I think we all really brought something different to the walkout. I think Shayla and Dominique really brought in the local aspect. They were the ones who wanted to talk about local gun violence and stories like that. So they really taught me how the issues that are going on in Parkland, they happen in Schenectady, like, every day, and it just doesn't make the headlines and stuff like that, and that's not okay.
It was really heavy when you actually speak to the families and, like, get their reactions, like, thank you for remembering my son or daughter. And it was a, I won't say complicated issue, but it was definitely, like, it was definitely different than anything we've ever done in high school, especially since we've never done a walkout before. It was like definitely one of the most impactful things I've done, and I was very proud to be a part of.
So connecting back to IB in a way, we all came into this idea for the walkout with different ideas instead of looking at it, oh, well, your idea is wrong, mine's better than yours. We took all of our ideas and we made it into one big event. And I think without IB, pre-IB Trevor would have been like, no, you're wrong, we're doing this. Post-IB Trevor was like, oh, like, let's combine all this, and it was more of a broader thinking.
I'm involved in the French club, jazz band, soccer, track. I mean, the soccer team is a work in progress. A lot of students and kids here are not really able to play soccer all year round like I am. So for a lot of them, it's just they only play it during the school season.
I am involved in cross country, indoor track, outdoor track. I started running in seventh grade. Most of my coaches told me I had pretty good endurance, so they told me I should probably try track when I get older, and so I did.
Track, I feel a very close bond with all the members of the team. It's just during every race or before every race, you just bond with your team. And I think it's just a great community and we all have a lot of fun on the team.
I don't actually like to run, I just like the team. And yeah, just like working out, staying in shape.
My favorite team is definitely cross country. It's because we definitely treat each other like family. We're always at each other's houses. We're always trying to do something together. And I feel like that's my favorite part about being part of a team, is being able to always hang out with your teammates and create a bond that you can't really create in a classroom. Running has really shaped my life because I feel like most people identify me as a runner. When they see me, it's like, oh, Matt's in a med. Oh, he runs, he's a pretty good runner. And I feel like that's definitely who I am, and that'll definitely always be a part of me.
I'm involved in swim, orchestra, band, or jazz band, and French club as well. Our swim team is pretty small because, I don't know, it's not a popular sport in Schenectady, but we're all very close because of it, and it's really nice that we have our own pool too, so.
I was in soccer, played basketball, but I seen my uncles play basketball, so I was like, you know what, I want to play basketball, I want to try a dunk one day. I started playing and I started liking it, and then soccer, I don't know, like, they put me in it as, like, when I was younger. And then I just started liking it and just getting better and better. So that's, like, my favorite sport now. So.
Sports, softball, soccer, that's about it.
I do a lot of stuff. I do ASL Club, Roots Club, Literacy Magazine Club, Voices of Schenectady. I take AVID, which is, like, a college preparation class.
I'm involved in our baseball team, National Honor Society, our student government, and JROTC. JROTC is, I would say it's a leadership program. Our main goal is to give kids a sense of responsibility they wouldn't have in other places in the school, and they could set better examples for the other students in the school.
Roots Club. It's a club that's a lot of people describe as like a social justice club. It does focus on like black people or like people of African descent, and we educate each other through discussions on different topics or whatever's going on throughout the world, or we do projects, like we had an art show, and we had like a variety show like in November. So we do different things, and we do murals around the school, so we kind of like merge art with like educating people about different ethnicities. I did one production and it was like kind of in collaboration with Ruth's Club for Fires in the Mirror. So it was a really powerful play. And then we did discussions with the audience right after the play. And I was one of the leading coordinators because I do discussions like about race in Ruth's Club. And it was really a unique experience. Definitely like one of the best of my high school experiences.
So the Rosa's Theater Company is a lot of fun. We're basically just like a big family of weirdos because we all love theater and we all put our time and effort into creating performances that we want, you know, the community and our school and the students and staff to enjoy.
Freshman year, the first show they did, I worked on it backstage and I learned a lot from that. I learned how lights work, how sound works, how costumes, everything works backstage. And then continuing freshman year, I started doing things on stage, and then from there on out up until junior year now, I've been doing things on stage. It has given me so much experience that I'm now going into things outside of school, like doing things at Proctor's or other community theaters where I already know so much things, I already have so much knowledge from here that I can easily take it with me.
I like drawing, so like studio art, because like I'm more of an artistic person and all that. And
like, yeah, there's like a huge variety for our classes. Right now I'm in IB art and we do like a whole bunch of different kind of arts and we like experience with different materials and things like that. And then I take drawing as well. And in that class, we like pay attention to like a lot of shading and mark making and things like that. We have like painting classes, sculpture classes, things like that.
I've been in the music program for like, I don't know, since fourth grade. And it's been a really good experience. I'm a special guest artist who I guess is as famous as like LeBron James in the jazz world, came by our school for a week and would come to our lessons.
I started orchestra here in ninth grade and then I really liked it a lot, but 10th grade I didn't really have time in my schedule to do it, so I wasn't really heartbroken about it, but then over the summer I really missed playing and I went back and played this year. The group and orchestra is really nice.
We don't have just like one choir or two choirs. We have like, I think we have five. I'm in four of them because I can't be in all five because one of them is a men choir, so I'm not a man. Yeah, I like them a lot because we have so much variety in the choirs and we have different levels of difficulty and I think it's really cool to be able to work your way up, you know, to each choir and yeah.
I'm here. I've been in Dance Connection for 2 years now. I take tap this year and I took intro to dance and I don't know, I really like it. I feel like it's different from what other schools teach and we try to like study different techniques and all of that stuff, and it's not just a dance class, like we do actual work and we take notes and we've done presentations, so I really like it.
For dancing, like it gives us like a lot of opportunity to perform, like for example, project dance, like a end of the year kind of dance, and it's really fun. It brings out my confidence, basically.
It really brightens my day whenever I go into the dance studio and I see Mr. Hatch and Ms. Reddick and Ms. Loss. The dance program has opened me up to so many other different types of dance. Like I just do ballet, tap, and point, and I've now been able to do dances in like African and hip hop and jazz and lyrical, and it's just a great way to learn, meet other people that also love dance and learn new types of dance.
I have a lot of gripes with this high school. For example, the fact that we live in an inner city area, and a lot of the administrators won't recognize that, or they choose not to acknowledge it, because the problems that face our high school are a lot different than they face other high schools, but they like to treat it the same way. Along with, like, administrators will just, like, befriend students and, like, just let them walk through the halls and do whatever they want. I just don't really agree with that, and I don't think that's all right.
I mean, I'll be in the middle of a class and there'll be kids, like, yelling in the hallway, and I'll be taking a test, and it's really distracting.
I think the hall monitors, I think they do a good job, but I think that we should have something in place where if kids are walking the halls, you don't give them high fives and you don't laugh at them. I think a kid needs to be yelled at every now and then to know what they're doing is wrong. And I think that rather than giving a high five of a kid or talking to them like they're your friend when they're in the hallway, you should discipline them, because you need to teach them what's right. You're doing them a bigger favor then. You're hurting them when you don't tell them they're wrong, because they're never going to know they're wrong. So I think we should really have hall monitors in our school where there's kids who are walking around the hallway not going to class, who tell them you need to go to class and aren't afraid to yell rather than just sit there and don't say anything.
The problem's like other people just like interacting with other people, because maybe some, like, I understand we're not gonna like everybody in life, but like just how people like interact, like people how people solve like problems, they just will solve it wrong. Like they'll get into an altercation or something, a fight and all that.
I think it's nothing based off the students. I think it's budget. A lot of the what's called again, like infrastructure here. I mean, if you walk through gym hallways, lockers are broken down. Like I never use the lockers in the gym, in the locker room in the gym, because it's not good enough for what we should have.
Outside of the school, people always think like we're such this negative kind of school, and we're always fighting and bullying and violence whenever they think of Schenectady High School.
Every time they hear about Schenectady, they're like, oh, Schenectady, what's that about? How is it like? Are there fights all the time? Are you always in lockdowns?
Let's say you never like had no part in Schenectady lifestyle, like you're from like, I'm just throwing it out there, like Boston Spa or something. Like people from there, they all they know is them, and they never like took the chance to experience Schenectady. So did like people say, oh, it's like ghetto and bad and all that, but if you never took the time out of your day or like just your year to see what it's like, then you're never gonna know. You're just gonna hear assumptions or assumptions. You're gonna go with those assumptions and that's what you're gonna think it is.
Most of the people I've met have viewed Schenectady as a negative way unless they have somebody that they know inside the district, and they're like, oh, Schenectady kids, I know a Schenectady kid and they're pretty cool, they do this, that, and the third. But I feel the people who don't know Schenectady and don't know the people that go to Schenectady have a really closed mind about who we are and what we do. So I think to perceive like a person from Schenectady as one thing is definitely wrong, because we're not just a group of people, we're all individuals and we're all unique, and I feel like that's the most important thing about Schenectady. I feel that the people outside of Schenectady that I meet definitely have a lot of similarities that some people in Schenectady do, and that they're not really different. We're all pretty much the same at the end of the day.
So everyone like says it's really bad, but I personally love it. I like all the opportunities that I have here, all the things I can do, and I love how there's like, there, since it's so big, I have freedom to do whatever I want to and all the clubs that there are. So, and I love all the people in my classes.
I think one of the advantages that Schenectady has versus other schools is our diversity.
Diversity, 100%. There's so many different people here. A lot of people, I mean, if I could go, let's say if I went to a private school, I mean, there's always going to be those individuals who go there who get in there through scholarships and stuff like that, but mostly it's people of the same, you know, background, people of the same income families, financial situations. So I like that there's so many people from different cultures and different financial classes here and all of that.
When you're exposed to so many forms of people and different types of backgrounds, religion, like gender, well, you know what I mean, just every different types of people and everything in any way, I think it becomes normal to you to be around different people, and it's just secondhand nature.
We're always like working together, and there's always somewhere like to go. Like everybody has like a group of friends or like just somebody that they can go to and talk to, and other schools are more like separated, and we're just all together.
I had actually did have the opportunity to go to Niskayuna High School before I came here, but I decided to go to school.
If I go to a different high school, I don't think I would. Just because I feel like at this high school, I'm Me personally, I feel like I take advantage of the opportunities that are given to me, and I like the opportunities that are presented to me in the school.
Schenectady is given a very bad rap, and I feel like everyone bonds over that.
Yeah,
and like,
yeah, for sure.
You can find your place. Everyone has a place, I feel like, whether it be band, theater, sports, academics. Oh. Everyone has their niche.
Yeah.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, go Patriots!